I'm Jamie Metzl, founder of OneShared.World, and on behalf of all of my colleagues at OneShared.World and our incredible partners all around the world, it's my incredible pleasure to welcome you to our event today on water and sanitation for all, the fight against pandemics. This is part of our Rise or Fall Together speaker series, where we are exploring not just the great challenges of this moment, but how we can come together as a world to best solve them. We are right now, all of us, at a turning point, a civilizational turning point, somewhat equivalent to 1918. And there are two paths ahead of us. One path forward is a path of exclusion and wall building, and another is inclusion and bridge building. Only that second path can allow our species and all of us to thrive. That's what OneShared.World and our whole community is all about. OneShared.World was formed in the earliest days of the pandemic out of a recognition that if we just solved COVID-19, but didn't address the broader issue of pandemics, we would be jumping out of the frying pan and into the fire. The same is true if we address pandemics, but not climate change or ecosystem destruction or proliferating weapons of mass destruction or global systemic poverty and inequality. Only by coming together to solve our greatest common challenges together will our species be able to thrive. Because our concept, our idea that we all share, that we need to build a new framework for global collaboration and problem solving based on the mutual responsibilities of a recognition of our deep interdependence, can't be abstract. It has to be made meaningful by solving very real problems that address the needs of very real people. And that's the lesson that this virus teaches us. We are all connected. If the virus grows and mutates anywhere, it threatens people everywhere. Addressing the urgent needs of the world's most vulnerable populations, therefore, isn't and can't be seen as just charity. It can't be seen as wealthier people helping poorer people. That's not the right framework. It must be seen as it is, as the best and smartest investment we can all make in building a safer world for everyone. We are all safer when the urgent needs of the world's most vulnerable populations are addressed. And that's what brings us to our topic today, of water and sanitation for all. We have actually coined a new term. It's a compound acronym connecting WASH, water sanitation and hygiene, and PAP, pandemic protection. And we believe that those words are more connected than they ever have been before. Addressing WASH isn't just about helping poor people. It's about coming together to build a safer world. The estimates are from Cambridge University that the cost of COVID-19 will be about $82 trillion over 5 years. What tiny fraction of that would we need to spend in order to build a safer world for everyone, to build a more resilient population that made us all safer? At OneShared.World, we believe we must have a systemic response to this systemic problem. That's why our WASHPAP campaign has focused on addressing this issue at every level, and we're going to explore all of them today. On a popular level, WASHPAP and the absence of it are experienced by very real people on the ground, and we're going to hear and see more of that when we connect with the amazing Shah Chowdhury and people in Bangladesh. And as part of the response, we also need to have a popular engagement. And that's why OneShared.World is partnering with Avaaz to reach out to many, many millions of people around the world at all levels and all backgrounds, inviting them to join this campaign. And certainly, I hope over the course of our conversation today, everybody will go to our OneShared.World/WASHPAP campaign page and look at the campaign, look at our reports, our petition, everything else that we're doing to drive attention and awareness and action to address the urgent needs of these most vulnerable populations. Civil society is also an essential part of this effort. And that's why We reached out and connected to many more than 100 civil society groups around the world who are working in these areas. And together, we have developed an outline plan for how safe water, basic sanitation and hygiene, and essential pandemic protection can be provided to every person on Earth by 2030. This is a fully achievable goal. And that brings us to the third part of our outreach, which is to governments. Governments play an essential role in our world today, and they can be an essential part of solving these kinds of problems. G20 leaders are meeting less than 2 weeks from now, and G20 represents about 84% of all of the world's wealth. We believe that in the context of this pandemic, there is a historic opportunity for the G20 to make a very strong statement that the only way we can each be safe is if we are all safe. And we have some very specific proposals on how WASHPAP can be the cornerstone of this kind of campaign. But this isn't about any one person, any one group, any one government. It's about the world coming together.